Now, two ships ran aground at the Batangas Pier on Thursday due to strong waves and winds brought by severe tropical storm Christine. Port manager Joselito Sino Cruz says the first vessel was a domestic cargo ship, lost its anchor while in the port, with its captain nowhere to be found. The second ship, meanwhile, is a foreign fuel tanker that had previously been detained by customs. Sino Cruz notes the fuel tanker was banned from the Batangas port due to its dangerous cargo, even in the absence of a storm. The incident also led to the port sustaining some damage.
Ang pinapalagay po natin ay nalagutan ito ng angkla. Nag-iimbestiga pa kung talagang pangalan talaga ay wala talagang kapitan ito. Pag pumasok po kayo sa loob ng Port of Batangas, amoy fuel na po. Sana nga po ay may ano pa, kung konti lang sana may salba.
Over 200 passengers are stranded at the Batangas port due to the adverse weather conditions caused by the storm. Meanwhile, more than 100 passengers left stranded at the Manila North port. This follows a slew of travel cancellations due to Christine. Some of the travelers say they chose to spend the night at the port to save on money as they await for authorities to finally allow the resumption of sea travel.
Wala pong daan ako, ma'am, kasi nakaupuan na lang ako, nagahiga. Mayroon man nagabigay ng pagkain dito, pero ngayon, ako ngayon, maliit na lang pera ko, ma'am, 200 lang naiwan dito. Pero nakabili na rin ako ng ticket.
Over in Quezon Province, two people are reported.
Hindi kami pwede umuwi ng Valenzuela kasi iniwasan din namin yung ano, yung pamasahe. Okay naman yung ano ng tugong yung mga tao. Okay naman yung pagtakato nila dito sa amin. Okay naman po yung pagkain. Mayroon naman po silang supply.
A boat carrying 10 fishermen sank in Bulacan early Thursday morning at the height of the storm. Karen De Guzman joins us for more details on this story. Karen, good morning. What can you tell us?
Finally, 9 individuals were rescued while 1 remains missing after a fishing boat capsized off the coast of Barangay Binuanan in Obando, Bulacan on Thursday morning. According to Barangay Chairman Samuel Rojas, all 10 fishermen were aboard the boat on Wednesday when they set out to fish. He mentioned that the wind and waves were calm when they initially set sail, but by evening, the weather had significantly worsened. It was morning when the family members of the fishermen received the devastating news. The said boat had capsized. Authorities said that approximately 15 kilometers, the capsized boat was 15 kilometers away from the shore. They are now conducting search and rescue operations, and the family members.
All right, Karen, are you still there? Anyway, we're having Karen Guzman. Yes, Karen, please continue. All right, we're trying.
Sorry, right now, together with the Philippine Coast Guard, the MDRRMO of Bulacan and the provincial government are conducting search and rescue operations. And the family members of the missing fisherman remain hopeful that he is still alive. Sandy?
All right, thank you so much for the update, Karen De Guzman. Karen De Guzman reporting to us about an incident in Ubando, Bulacan, where 9 fishermen were rescued while 1 remaining missing. They set sail Thursday in the water 16 kilometers offshore when weather worsened and the boat they were on capsized. And rescue authorities are still scouring the area for 1 remaining fisherman who is missing. We'll have more details on that developing story later. Several towns submerged in flood waters in Quezon Province, affecting more than 11,000 individuals. Our correspondent, Dennis Datu, filed this report.
The weather conditions here in Quezon Province gradually improving, although signal number 2 is still raised in the northern and central parts of Quezon, while other areas remain under signal number 1. Last night, the floodwaters in the town of Catanawan began to recede, allowing many vehicles and motorists who had been stranded since Tuesday night to pass through the highway leading to the town. Mayor Matt Erwin Florido of General Luna is appealing for additional relief goods from the national government. According to Mayor Florido, although they have stockpiles of relief goods, it will not be enough to meet the needs of the affected residents in their town, which number up to 4,500 families. The mayor also said that this is the most severe flooding the town of General Luna has experienced in the past 29 years, with the last occurrence being during Typhoon Busing in 1995. Flooding also hit 27 barangays, and some of them floodwaters reached the roofs of houses. Local government and the DPWH are continuing their clearing operations on the roads affected by landslides in various towns, particularly in Mulanay Town. According to the Quezon Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, 9 towns experienced flooding due to Typhoon Tropical Storm Christine, including Lopez, Calawag, San Francisco, San Narciso, Buena Vista, Mulanay, Pitogo, Catanawan, and General Luna. The Quezon PD Arms IMO is still verifying whether the reported deaths of 2 residents are related to severe tropical storm Christine. Approximately 11,500 individuals in Quezon have been affected by the severe tropical storm Christine. Electricity supply is also gradually being restored in the towns in the Bundok Peninsula area that were affected by the flood.
Over in Quezon Province, 2 people are reported dead, while over 30,000 more have been affected by the storm. The province's Governor Helen Tan says evacuees may soon return to their homes, possibly in 1 or 2 days. Tan adds one of the province's municipalities has already declared a state of calamity.
Well, we're still awaiting yung other data kasi alam mo naman merong kailangan justification declaration. But the municipalities ay sinabihan ko sila, mga mayors, if they think kailangan magdeklara na doon sa level nila.
Sa localities po nila.
State of calamity. Opo. So we have one. Yesterday, nagpaalam sa akin si Mayor Carlo ng Tagkawayan at talaga namang devastated yung area.
Strong winds batter parts of Tanay Rizal, which remains under signal number 2. EZ Lee filed this report.
This morning, a tree fell along Tanay Pililla Road, causing only one lane to be passable to motorists. The winds are very strong this morning here in Tanay Rizal. However, barangay officials have already cleared the fallen tree. According to the Rizal Provincial Government, the province remains under signal number 2. Stronger rains and winds are being experienced in the eastern part of Rizal, including Tanay, Pililla, Halahala, and Morong. As of 6 a.m., water levels in Wawa Dam and San Mateo River are still below critical levels, but are continuously being monitored by PDRRMO. Main roads like Marcos Highway, Sumulong Highway, and others are still passable and free from flooding. According to the latest report from PDRRMO, 183 families or more than 600 individuals have been evacuated from 13 barangays as a preemptive measure. The 24-hour operation of DRRMC is activated and evacuation centers in each town of Rizal are prepared. Rescue personnel are also on standby for deployment if needed.
At least 14 people have been reported dead, while thousands are evacuated due to severe tropical storm Christine, the 11th cyclone to hit the country this year, affecting nearly the entire Luzon and Visayas and parts of Mindanao. The Bicol region, among the hardest hit, where many areas remain submerged in water. The non-stop rains also caused lahar flow from the Mayon volcano. Christine made landfall over Divilakan, Isabela, past midnight, and as of 5 this morning, has gradually decelerated while moving northwestward over northern Luzon. Several provinces in northern Luzon have been placed under signal number 3, while Metro Manila and a dozen others are under signal number 2. Incessant rains brought by severe tropical storm Christine have triggered landslides and severe flooding across the Philippines. About 5 million people in the typhoon-hit areas are without power, and parts of the national highway have become waterlogged. The National Disaster Management Office reports nearly 300 roads and bridges are now impassable due to flooding. In Isabela, where Christine made landfall earlier today, 7 bridges have already overflowed. Crops also devastated by the floods. 4 are meanwhile reported dead in Catanduanes due to a landslide in Caramoran. Mindanao also not spared by the wrath of Christine. About 3,000 families in Maguindanao del Sur were displaced due to the floods. Data from the NDRRMC show more than 2 million individuals have been affected by the storm, while 18 cities and municipalities have also been placed under a state of calamity. The Social Welfare Department, meanwhile, vows the government is on top of the situation.
The national stockpile of family food packs ng DSWD ay nasa mahigit 1.9 million. Dahil nga, before Christine ay nasa mahigit 2 million ito, but since we've already started augmenting the resources of the local government units, particularly in the Bicol region, nabawasan na po yung stockpile natin. However, ongoing pa rin naman yung ating production doon sa major hub na total humanitarian assistance already extended by the DSWD is more than 55 million pesos na po.
Moving on now, classes in all levels and work in government offices in Luzon suspended today, Thursday. Malacañang says suspension of work for private companies and offices is left to the discretion of the respective heads. However, agencies whose functions involve delivery of basic and health services, as well as disaster response and preparedness, shall continue with their operations. Metro Manila officials send a 30-man team to the Bicol region to assist with rescue operations. Rescue efforts there have been hindered by unexpectedly widespread flooding. The team consists of trained rescuers who will bring equipment, including chainsaws and aluminum and fiberglass boats. A price freeze on basic commodities now in effect in areas under a state of calamity due to severe tropical storm Christine. This is according to the Philippine Trade Department. Under a state of calamity, a 60-day automatic price freeze is imposed on key commodities such as canned fish, instant noodles, bottled water, and bread. The agency is now monitoring prices and supply levels of products in all affected areas. The Pharmaceutical and Healthcare Association of the Philippines warns of possible delays in replenishing stocks in pharmacies affected by Christine. This is due to widespread flooding and impassable roads. PHAP assures that there are still adequate stocks of crucial medicines for colds, cough, and flu throughout the country, and its member companies continue to operate amid the storm. Another low-pressure area forms outside the Philippine Area of Responsibility. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says the LPA is around 2,400 kilometers east of northeastern Mindanao as of Thursday morning. It adds there is a high chance that the weather disturbance will develop into a tropical depression in the next 24 hours and may enter PAR early next week.